Hello and welcome to this new video where we will talk about scale, because there was a question, okay, can you say something about scale and what scale we use when things? Okay, so what's the scale? Scale is a concept where we will talk about the combination of real size to imaginary size. And let's have a look here on this good old fellow, right? A Lego bus, potential size 20 centimeters in length. And let's assume we talk about a scale of 1 to 50. That means this one might have a scale of 1 to 50. That means that the 20 centimeters length multiplied by 50 means in real size, it might have a length of 20 times 50, 1000 centimeters. So we keep the unit. 20 times 50 means 1000 centimeters. That is in total length approximately 10 meters. So that works quite fine for this model, right? If we would say, well, it's a scale of 1 to 100. 20 times 100 means it's 20 meters long. Quite long for a bus. So, but the other question is, what scale we use when we would like to create a map. When we are creating a map, we always need to make sure, okay, what sort of information would we like to show, right? I've shown you the bus, approximately size to put this on a sheet of paper is just a drawing like it is, right? And say, well, scale 1 to 50. But let's assume we are not interested in the bus, but the location of the bus on the road in Europe. Are we really into 1 to 50? That means we need to scale the whole of Europe onto one piece of paper, and that will not work, right? So if you have a large area, then you need to increase the scale. If you have a small area to show on the map, you could decrease the scale, right? So normal maps for showing property on a piece of land, most likely 1 to 5,000 in scale. Topographic maps of Germany tend to be in 1 to 1 million or something like that, 1 to 250,000, 1 to 500,000. And but let's talk about the so this is the area what you would like to show on the map and how much can fit into a map. So if you would like to show a lot of or large areas, you need to increase the scale. But what about the details? So if you increase this, let's take it with the 1 to 50, right? So 1 to 50, are we then really interested in that little knob over there? So this one, this little fellow there in the sketchy part. No, we are not interested in that knob. We would like to see the whole bus, right? So depending on the scale, we need to talk about the details. So let's assume you have a geometry of a garden or of a park area, right? And you would like to show it on a map of whole Germany. Do you really need all the geometry information, or do you just need a tiny rectangle on the map? So you could decrease or simplify or generalize the park geometry. And that's that. So it is always a burden. So sometimes you need to show a lot of content, a lot of feature, a lot of details. So if you need to communicate a lot of details, then you need to go down with the scale, like 1 to 400 or 1 to 100. And if you need to just show large areas, then you need to increase the scale, but you can also boil down the geometries to the minimum that is needed to conceive the information, right? To communicate what the other should see. So in terms of our example, where we with QGIS and the QGIS lessons, so we analyzed buildings and the position of buildings. I was showing a lot of small, tiny buildings, right? But if you take a look at South Africa, this could be boiled down to points on the map. So there is no need to have a polygon in the end, right? So that's that. It is a little bit different and dependent on the information, the area, and the detail, what scale you should use. But let's have a look on QGIS.
So what we see here is one example in QGIS where we analyzed some features regarding the some criteria, right? So there is a building over here. Let's have a look here. This building, this is now visualized on the screen. And we will take not the scale 1 to 485, but 1 to 500. And let's make sure that the EPSG code is correct here. In my case, it is an EPSG code where I can really measure, right? So I can measure on the screen. And by saying so, let's have a look how big this polygon is. You will not see this, but I will take care that I will measure it correctly with my meter here or with my ruler. So it's 7.2 centimeters. Let's do the mass. 7.2, calculator app, 7.2 times 500 should be something around 36 meters. So let's have a look and use the measure tool. So we'll go here to measure tool. Let's create a new measurement from here up to there. So it's 37.4 meters. Due to the fact that I'm measuring on the screen and we have a conversion in the screen from DPI, so dots or dots per inch. I have a high resolution screen and something the uncertainties are aware, but we are quite fine. So a scale that means 7.2 centimeters means 35, 36-ish meters in the real world. So if I'm increasing this size here now, if I'm increasing the scale, well, first of all, I don't see any real, I don't see the details anymore, right? And if I go even further, so I'm increasing the scale even more, let's go here, it seems like there are not so many features anymore, right? And that's what I'm saying when I'm talking about, okay, depending on the level of information, the quality of information, and what you would like to communicate. This scale, 1 to 100,000, I think it is, it's not suited to communicate the location of the buildings in Swellendam. No way at all, right? But if I'm zooming in a little bit, this is a good scale. I'm not able to measure the things I see here because they're 2 millimeters away from each other or something like that, right? And then the length of the buildings or the area of buildings is freakishly small. So, but it's still a good way to communicate, right? We can see the buildings where they are. We get an idea about the shape of the buildings. So I don't need to use the point layer here anymore. But still, this is not suitable to get an idea about the area of a rectangle. But to make things even worse, you need to keep one thing in mind. Different projections tend to work with scales, and some don't. So let's have a look on Google Maps, right? You remember Google Maps, largest Greenland, tiny Africa. Scale is not working with this concept, right? Because if you would like to apply the scale to this direction, then Greenland is quite long. You can only apply the scale to the east and west direction. So keeping that in mind, let's have a look on the scales used in Google Maps. So these are the scales. Well, this is a little bit freaky, right? So we are normally working with proper scales like 1 to 500, 1 to 1000 and stuff like that. Does not work in here. So you don't even have integers as scales. So just to keep that in mind, if you would like to work with the scales, you have here a scale to 1 to, well, that's how many? 1000, 1 to 500 million. What the heck, right? And so there are different scales of use in Google Maps that are not even not even integers. They are broken down, and you have a city level here on scale A on zoom level 18. And so as said, sometimes these property maps are scaled on 1 to 5,000. This is a normal scale. but you can go even down a little bit, like 1 to 1000 with the zoom level here of level 20. So I hope that explains somehow how to work with scales, that it, and to boil it down in the end, like scale depends on what extent you would like to show the people to see. What is the detail of information you would like to see, you would like to show, right? Remember this little fellow. And what geometry is really needed to show that information, right? So there are different things to keep in mind to select the proper scale. And it also depends, of course, on the medium you would like to show, right? Or you would like to print out if it's a Dyna 4 paper, or it's Dyna 0, or it is a slippy map where you don't need to really take care of the scale because you can zoom in and zoom out, right? So always depends on different aspects, and it's I would like to say it's not an easy task to select the proper scale for a map. But you will get used to it. Thank you very much for watching. Take care and goodbye.